Bonjour, c'est Virginie, and you are watching French Truly TV, your destination to truly become a little bit French. Today and next week, I want to share with you the 10 most popular French verbs, in other words, crucial verbs for you to absolutely know by heart. What gave me the idea for this video is the online product I recently launched on my website, FrenchTruly.com, called 600 Words. This online course will prove to you you can express yourself like the average French person with only 600 words. You will gain access to 15 videos plus 10 bonus ones to help and accompany you every step of the way through the course. Plus, for each word, each sentence, each expression, each conjugated verb, I have created an audio file of my voice, slow and slightly faster speed, adding the registration link to this product in the description section. But for now, let's have a look at the 5 most popular French verbs, and next week in part 2, I'll give you the other 5. Just to warn you, these first 5 verbs are all irregular, which means they're not as easy to learn because they're not regular. But it's really important for you to learn them. So, to help you, I will conjugate each verb in the present tense and make a purposely very simple short sentence to accompany every single subject. Just so you know, the sentences are a lot deeper in the 600 words course. I'm keeping it extra simple here in this video you're watching to focus on the conjugation of verbs while producing a short enough and quickly digestible video. Are you ready? Or should I say, vous êtes prêts? 1. The top one is, of course, être, to be. It's used in French as much as it's used in English, all the time. You will notice it is irregular. I am happy. Je suis contente. Je suis contente. You are handsome. Tu es beau. That's the casual you. Tu es beau. She is late. Elle est en retard. Elle est en retard. He is lost. Il est perdu. Il est perdu. We are the best group. Nous sommes le meilleur groupe. Nous sommes le meilleur groupe. You are on the picture. Vous êtes sur la photo. That's the formal you or you all. Vous êtes sur la photo. They are too impatient. Elles sont trop impatientes. Elles sont trop impatientes. That's if you're talking about women. And ils sont trop impatients if you're talking about men or a mixed group. Ils sont trop impatients. The second most used French verb is avoir, to have, also irregular. I have 2 dogs. J'ai 2 chiens. J'ai 2 chiens. You have a big car. Tu as une grosse voiture. That's the casual you. Tu as une grosse voiture. She has a lot of money. Elle a beaucoup d'argent. Elle a beaucoup d'argent. He has a headache. Il a mal à la tête. Il a mal à la tête. We have a few questions. Nous avons quelques questions. Nous avons quelques questions. You have everything. Vous avez tout. That's the formal you or you all. Vous avez tout. They have a marvelous family. Elles ont une merveilleuse famille. Elles ont une merveilleuse famille. That's if you're talking about women. And ils ont une merveilleuse famille if you're talking about men or a mixed group. Ils ont une merveilleuse famille. The third most used French verb is aller. Aller, to go. I'm going on vacation tomorrow. Je vais en vacances demain. Je vais en vacances demain. Are you going to the theater with him? Tu vas au cinéma avec lui? That's the casual you. Tu vas au cinéma avec lui? She is going to the United States. Elle va aux États-Unis. Elle va aux États-Unis. He goes to the cafe with his wife. Il va au café avec sa femme. Il va au café avec sa femme. We go to the concert together. Nous allons au concert ensemble. Nous allons au concert ensemble. You go to France once a year. Vous allez en France une fois par an. That's the formal you or you all. Vous allez en France une fois par an. They're going to the market. Elles vont au marché. That's if you're talking about women. Elles vont au marché. Or ils vont au marché. If you're talking about men or a mixed group, ils vont au marché. The fourth most used French verb is pouvoir, can, or be able to, or be allowed to. Can I tell you something? Je peux te dire quelque chose. Je peux te dire quelque chose. You can speak English. Tu peux parler français. That's the casual you. Tu peux parler français. She can leave now. Elle peut partir maintenant. Elle peut partir maintenant. He can hear our conversation. Il peut entendre notre conversation. Il peut entendre notre conversation. We can be heroes. Nous pouvons être des héros. Nous pouvons être des héros. You can call me tonight. Vous pouvez m'appeler ce soir. That's the formal you or you all. Vous pouvez m'appeler ce soir. They can dance all night long. Elles peuvent danser toute la nuit. That's if you're talking about women. Elles peuvent danser toute la nuit. And ils peuvent danser toute la nuit if you're talking about men or a mixed group. The fifth most used French verb is vouloir, to want. And good news, it's conjugated just like pouvoir. One nice thing about the irregular verbs is that you will find a lot of recurring patterns throughout them all. I want everything. Je veux tout. Je veux tout. You want to invite me. Tu veux m'inviter. And that's the casual you. Tu veux m'inviter. She wants her coffee now. Elle veut son café maintenant. Elle veut son café maintenant. He wants to speak French. Il veut parler français. Il veut parler français. We want to come with you. Nous voulons venir avec vous. Nous voulons venir avec vous. You want a big picnic. Vous voulez un gros pique-nique. That's the formal you or you all. Vous voulez un gros pique-nique. They want a house in the countryside. Elles veulent une maison à la campagne. That's if you're talking about women. Elles veulent une maison à la campagne. And ils veulent une maison à la campagne if you're talking about men or a mixed group. Have you noticed the similarity between the conjugated versions of pouvoir, can, and vouloir, to want? That's one of the nice things about the French irregular verbs. Yes, they take a little longer to remember than regular verbs, but if you pay attention, there are lots of little tricks to help your memory. And stay tuned, because next week I will share with you the other 5 verbs, so you'll have your full and very useful list of the 10 most commonly used verbs in French. If you like this video and you want more, subscribe. If you want to read this blog post so you can see in one spot all these verbs written down, go to my website frenchtruly.com/blog, where if you feel like saying merci for all the videos I've been producing over the years, about 120 so far, you can donate. And last but not least, when you're on my website, make sure to subscribe for free to my 3-step mini course to help you become a little bit French. Merci beaucoup, au revoir et gros bisous!